Welkom bij een nieuwe aflevering van 2 Meter Sessies. Vandaag opname 1515 met Engelsman Fink, die 11 jaar geleden debuteerde met heel andere muziek dan waar hij vandaag de dag na mee maakt. Die muziek waar hij vandaag de dag na mee maakt, daar debuteerde hij uiteindelijk mee in 2006. Toen hij zo moe was geworden van zichzelf en het vele dansen, dat hij zei: ik ben toe aan folkmuziek, de muziek waar ik ooit mee begonnen ben als muzikant. De muziek die zijn vader ook speelde en zijn opa. En zo kennen we Fink het beste. Inmiddels een nieuw album uit, Perfect Darkness, waar hij vandaag een aantal nummers van zal spelen. Maar voordat we toe zijn aan Fink en het gesprek met hem, eerst een nummer uit het archief van de 2 Meetsessies van de band Lamb, afkomstig uit Manchester. Muziek waar hij wel wat mee heeft, volgens mij. Geniet van de 2 Meetsessie van Lamb uit 1997. Hier is Lusty.
When I close my eyes, I could hear you talking in the background, you sod.
Old school.
Yeah, old school. Yeah. 1997.
Is that called drum and bass? Is it drum and bass?
It's coming from Manchester.
The sound of Manchester.
Yeah, you had something in common with the guys from Lamb, did you?
Yeah, we got loads in common with those guys. They've been a big part of our little journey, actually. Lou Rhodes gave us our first support, I think, in Holland, at Paradiso, which was really cool. We got kicked out of the venue for talking, ironically enough. And then Basement Jack stole our dressing room. Is that that night?
That's what happened, yeah.
That's what happens when you're at the bottom of the tree.
But also Andy did production on your second
album. And Andy, so that was Lou, and Lou's been a great supporter. We've supported a lot in London. And Andy produced the second album, Distance and Time, in his house, which was great.
Yeah.
Bless him. And John Thorne's been a good friend since the early days, because he played with Lou Rhodes. He said some really great things, encouraging words. And he's been at loads of our gigs, and yeah, we love that guy.
Mm.
It's very interesting to see him play an electric guitar with a wah-wah pedal on that one, and I think Guy will be emailing him later.
Yeah, definitely.
But why is it special? Because he never plays it?
Because he's like definitely one of the world's best live bass players. I would definitely think that he's certainly top five in my opinion. Okay. And there he was playing an electric guitar, going wacka 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 wacka
meow. With no beard.
With no beard. Yeah. Mm. Now he sports a big beard. Of course.
Like you.
Who doesn't?
Yeah. This is session number 4 by Fink. The first one we did in 2006.
Yeah, wow.
And one of the things that you said at that session, I'm actually starting a nice journey. I came from the beats and I'm into the acoustic guitar again.
Yeah.
How's the journey going?
Still haven't got there, but it's great, man. Journey's awesome. It's been since that session, it's been a roller coaster for all of us, like just a constant blur of writing, recording, touring, writing, recording, and touring 4 albums later, and we're touring.
Yeah.
Happy days.
But the things you said in 2006 was, I got so much rid of the beats, I wanted to relax.
Right.
With my acoustic.
Definitely relaxed.
Are you?
Yeah.
Because of that scheme of traveling, recording.
Yeah. Life doesn't really get in the way, because you're always recording, writing, or touring. It's been awesome, and the more gigs you do, the less nervous you get, and the more writing you do, the better you get. So yeah, it's been an awesome journey, and it's really weird because Lou Rhodes gave us our first ever gig in Holland at Paradiso, and we were like, wow, this place is enormous, and we're playing there on the 20th. As a headline, which is great. Good. It's been a real, like, lovely
circle.
Journey in Holland. Yeah.
Yeah. Your latest album is called Perfect Darkness. If you compare the stuff that you do on this album to your first solo album, what is the difference? Is there a difference? Apart from the songs, of course.
It wasn't recorded in my loft. Yeah. That's quite a significant difference. Recorded instead of being recorded in a Brighton attic with 3 microphones, it was recorded in a Los Angeles studio with a innumerable amount of microphones, which is great. And the producer on the new album, Billy Bush, knows what he's doing, as opposed to an ex-DJ with 2 mates trying to get it together, which was cool. And Biscuits for Breakfast took about a year, and Perfect Darkness took 2 weeks. So it's a totally different experience. And we can play and sing, and we're better at doing what we're supposed to do.
So you've gotten better in recording, in writing songs?
Well, not necessarily better at writing songs, but just better at knowing what I can sing. But by the time you get to your 4th album, if you don't know what kind of artist you are, then, I don't know, it'd be a bit tricky. But we've spent 3 albums learning who we are as musicians. And so on this record, we wanted to nail, you know, who we were at the moment, and all of our good bits and sweet spots, some sick bass lines, some dope beats and guitar from Mr. T. And
if I would be asking you today, what sort of artist are you, what would you say?
Well, we touch so many like genres, whether accidentally or deliberately. It's like totally subconscious, I reckon, but we're like folk and indie and acoustica and, you know, a bit of soul and a bit of blues and influenced by loads of dead heroes and influenced by loads of new bands, and I don't know, we're a real mixture of loads of different sounds. But I think the overriding thing is we're a very acoustic band.
And very eclectic.
eclectic, but with the framework is the fact that our instruments are acoustic, or at least there's only three of us.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I'm not playing electric, so that kind of defines the sound a little bit.
Your father used to be a folk musician as well.
Mm.
If you compare the stuff that he did and what you do, is it comparable?
No, mine's totally different, and I'm a bit more extreme than my dad, so his music's quite nice and and meadows and flowers and very Celtic, very Scottish, very Irish, whereas my music's very kind of American and and influenced by the British musicians that were influenced by the American musicians in the 70s, so totally different. And we've never jammed either. It's horrible when we jam. Because he's all fluid and folky and traditional, and I'm all hitting and punchy and...
That's American.
And ragged. Yeah, maybe more passion than skill, but yeah, no. He taught me a lot about skill and technique, but I ignored it all, basically. Which is good. It's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Good. We played a song by Lamb. I would love to show you a song by Lou Rhodes.
Yeah, totally. She's actually signed to Ninja now, a Ninja Tune in a roundabout way.
But she's back with Lamb again.
Yeah, that's right. They reformed, yeah.
She's also back with the solo tour as a folk musician.
Yeah, no, she's lovely solo. It's really, really nice. She's really, really cool. And we saw Lamb at Big Chill, didn't we? Well, you did.
Yeah.
And the new Lamb, and they were wicked. Just the three of them, no extra stuff, no whistles and pyrotechnics and stupid shit. Just the three of them just doing it. And guy said it was awesome.
Yeah, they were really good.
We missed them at Lowlands. I saw Warpaint instead. I felt a bit guilty about that, but I really wanted to see Warpaint, and we saw him afterwards, and they were having a great time. You know?
Okay, let's play some Lou Rhodes now.
Yeah,
yep.
Let's see a bit of Lou.
Takes is one, just one.
nice. It's again Manchester in the show.
That was really nice, man. She's lovely when she does that kind of stuff.
When Lem came up, well, we all talked about Manchester scene and the Bristol sound. Is there anything that's in common what they have? Is there?
I don't know. Very different vibe. Bristol is very chilled out, and Manchester's a bit more spiky and edgy, and they're very, very different. I mean, I wouldn't necessarily say that Lamb were part of the Manchester sound. I think they're a bit more part of the heritage of the Bristol sound,
mm-hmm.
but they just happen to be from Manchester. Mm. Manchester to me is, well, Woo Life, you know that band Woo Life at the moment? That's very Manchester, group of kids, bit crazy, don't care, noisy craziness.
Go hellfire.
Yeah. For sure.
Okay. I think it's time for you guys to show us something of the sound of Fink.
Nice, yeah, love
2011. Here's the Meter Sessies from Fink.